Hello students, in today's physics class we are going to learn about speed and velocity. Now what is speed? Speed means it is a distance traveled in per unit time. That is your speed is equal to distance traveled by time taken. So in words we can say distance traveled by a body in a unit time is called speed. Now speed does not have any direction. It has only magnitude. Since it has only magnitude, so it is considered as a scalar quantity. Because scalar quantities are the quantities which have only magnitude, no direction. Now in which unit we can measure speed? We can measure speed in terms of meter per second. If you want to find the bigger unit of speed, then you can use kilometer per hour. So kilometer per hour is also the unit of speed, but this one is considered as a bigger unit. Another point is speed cannot be zero. In our previous part we learned that distance cannot be zero. If your distance cannot be zero, then speed is also cannot be zero. So what is speed? Speed is the distance traveled by a body in a unit time. It is also called as a rate of change of motion. Its SI unit is meter per second. It cannot be zero and it is a scalar quantity, and the bigger unit is your kilometer per hour. Now we should know about the average speed also. Average speed means if the body changes its distance, same body changing the distance in different time. Like the body first traveled 200 meter in 5 seconds, then 600 meter in 8 seconds. The same body is traveling the different distance in the same time. So on that time we have to find the average speed by using total distance by total time. So for this case, what will be the total distance? Total distance will be your 6 plus 2 will be 800, and the total time will be your 13. So 800 by 13 will give you the average speed. So average speed we have to use whenever the same body traveling the different distance in different time. So simple formula you have to use: average speed is equal to total distance traveled by total time taken. Now come to the velocity. Velocity means speed with direction. Suppose we are considering the motion of a car going in north direction. The wind is flowing in a south direction. So in this way, we can say speed with direction is called velocity. So we can say velocity of wind, velocity of water, because water is also flowing in specific direction. Like your wind is blowing in a specific direction. So speed with direction, whenever you consider the speed with direction, then that is called as a velocity. Or you can say velocity is equal to displacement divided by time taken. Now its SI unit is same, meter per second. It means velocity also we measure in terms of meter per second. And the vigor unit, again it is kilometer per hour. Then it's SI unit, okay, SI unit is meter per second and it can be zero. Now see, why it can be zero? Because velocity is equal to displacement by time. And we know that displacement can be zero. In which case displacement can be zero? Whenever the body comes back to the original position, if then displacement is zero. Suppose body is starting from the point A and is back to the point A. On that time, the displacement will be zero. If the displacement is zero, sure and certain your velocity is also zero. And it is a vector quantity. Yes, because here we are considering both magnitude and direction. So velocity is your vector quantity. Now, velocity can be your uniform, it can be your non-uniform, or it can be your average velocity. Uniform velocity means when the object travels equal distance in equal interval of time, then the velocity is called uniform velocity. This is exactly same as your uniform motion. You can check this definition from your copy, physics copy. Now, non-uniform velocity is the same as your non-uniform motion. When the body covers unequal distance in equal interval of time, then the velocity is said to be non-uniform velocity. Same. Uniform velocity means uniform motion. Non-uniform velocity means non-uniform motion. So you can write the same definition for both uniform velocity and uniform motion, or non-uniform velocity or non-uniform motion. Now come to the next, average velocity. Average velocity means if the velocity of changing uniformly for a uniform motion. If the body is in the uniform motion, on that time you can find the average velocity by using initial velocity plus final velocity divided by 2. That is, this is the symbol V. AV means average. Average is also called as a mean. So average velocity is equal to U plus V divided by 2. Now I have given here an example that 0 meter, the body come in 0 second. Body covers 100 meter in 1 second, 200 meter in 2 second, and 300 meter in 4 second. So all these are in uniform. So if you take these two readings, so what is the initial? The symbol of initial velocity is your U. So U is equal to 0, and here final velocity V will be your what? V will be 100 by 1, that is your 100 meter per second. So put in this formula, 0 plus 100 meter per second divided by 2, which is equal to 50 meter per second. Similarly, if you take these two readings, here first find out the velocity, this is distance divided by time, 100 by 1, this is your initial velocity. Then take the second reading, that one will be your 200 divided by 2, again it will be 100, so 100. So initial is your 100, final velocity is also 100, what will be your average? That is 100 plus 100 divided by 2, which is equal to 200 by 2, which is equal to 100. It means whenever the body changes its velocity in uniform rate, then we can use the formula initial velocity plus final velocity divided by 2. That is U plus V by 2. U is the symbol of initial velocity. v is the symbol of final velocity. So here we have completed the introduction of speed and velocity. Now check the numerical on speed. So numerical on speed is your, I have taken from your book only, practice problem number 1, part 1. So in this question, a cyclist covers a distance of 50 meter in 10 seconds. Calculate the speed of the cyclist in meter per second and in kilometer per hour. Let's start solution for number 1. Distance, first you write distance is equal to 50 meter. Time is equal to 10 seconds. So what will be your speed? Speed is equal, or you can write time taken also. So distance by time taken. No need to write too much. Just write down a direct formula. Distance will be your 50 meter. Time taken is your 10 second. So 0, 0 get cancelled. So 5 meter per second is your answer of the first part. That is speed equal to 5 meter per second. Now, in the second part, we have to convert this 5 meter per second into kilometer per hour. So, for kilometer per hour, we should know certain conversion. Like, now part 2. 1 kilometer is equal to 1000 meter. Then, if you can write 1 by 1000, just bring this 1000 here. So, here it will be only 1 meter. It means, if 1 kilometer is equal to 1000 meter, then 1 meter is equal to 1 by 1000 kilometer. Now, similarly for hour, 1 hour is equal to 60 minutes. And 1 minute again have 60 seconds. So this become 3600 seconds. So 1 hour is equal to your how many seconds? 3600 seconds. So again you bring this one here. 1 by 3600 hour is equal to 1 second. I hope this is clear. 1 meter is equal to 1 by 1000 kilometer. 1 second is equal to 1 by 3600 hour. So we have to convert what? Speed is equal to 5 meter per second. So this is 5 into, in place of meter, this one, in place of meter, what you have to write? 1 by 1000 kilometer. And in place of second, because this is per second, it means divided by second. So 1 second, what you have to write? 1 by 3600. So solve it. This is 5 by 1000 into 3600 by 1 second. Just reciprocal it. 1 by 3600 will become 3600 by 1 second. So cancel these 2 zeros. Then cancel by 5, 5 into 5, 5 to the 10, 36 by 2, so 2 into 2, 218 into 36. Answer is 18 kilometer per hour. So in this way, you have to convert the meter per second in kilometer per hour. So what you have to remember? This one. 1 meter is equal to 1 by 1000 kilometer, and 1 second in place of second you have to put 1 second is equal to 1 by 3600 hour. Now in the Second question, this is problem, practice problem number part one. Number one, question number two, you have to do yourself. The same way as this question, only the difference is, here time is given as a 2 minute. So, you have to convert this 2 minute into second. 1 minute is equal to how many seconds? 60 seconds. So, 2 into 60 will be 120 seconds. So, 2 into 60 is equal to, it will be 120 seconds. After that, use the speed formula, find out the first part. And for the second part, you have to convert into kilometer per hour, same as this question. So, do yourself. Now, what you have to do, you have to write this part in your classwork copy and solve the practice problem number 1, both the part 1 and 2 in your copy as your assignment. Thank you.